In this video, you get two templates for Premiere Pro to enhance your videos. Hello and welcome guys, Armagan Videos here, and this video is not a regular tutorial. This is more like a giveaway video. You can get two templates for Premiere Pro in this video. One fashion template for like beauty YouTubers or people that have very abstract and modern fashionable content on their YouTube channel. And one lifestyle template, which is for vloggers or people that really create epic cinematics during their travels or trips or whatever. Generally for people that are making videos like Sam Calder, in case you know him. They are super easy to customize and totally free, so check the description to download these templates and watch the end of this video for an explanation and a tutorial on how to use these templates. One important note though, you need to have the After Effects and Premiere Pro CC 2017 April release version because only these support these new motion graphics templates, and I made a video about these new templates which you can see in the top right corner right now, so make sure to check that out in case you are having any questions for the new motion graphics templates. If you like this video and these templates, make sure to comment, like and subscribe so that I know that I should continue with creating these videos. And now let's hop right into Premiere Pro and work with these new templates. So there we are at my desktop, and as you can see we get the fashion and lifestyle templates just here, and they are called .mogrt, which means motion graphics templates. And yeah, pretty self-explanatory: fashion template, lifestyle template, as you've just seen in the beginning in this little introduction that I've showed you, and also a folder called footage, which is just for the purpose of the presentation in the beginning. And let's actually start Premiere Pro. Click on new project and yeah, whatever kind of name you want to give it, I'm just going to call it your video. And as you can see right here, Premiere needs a sequence, so go to file, new sequence, and let's just call it your sequence, AVCHD 1080p 30fps, click OK, and there we go. And I've already opened this essential graphics panel right here. Make sure to update your Premiere if you don't see this, and then go to window, essential graphics, make sure to enable this and drag the panel to the place where you want to see it. And if you now go to the top right, you can see this little icon, install motion graphics template. Make sure to select the lifestyle first, and you can now see it got imported into your selection right here. And if you drag this into your sequence now, Premiere might ask you if you want to change the sequence settings. Yeah, just right here, and just click change, because maybe I think the templates that I've made are 29.97 fps and the sequence was 30 fps, so there's kind of a little disbalance right there. And you can now see there's our animation, perfectly fine. Let's click on this little wrench and hit loop so it always loops. And yeah, there's our cool lifestyle animation which you've seen in the beginning as well. And all these animations are working just fine. If you now drag in your footage just beneath our template right here. Yeah, lags a little bit. Boom, there it is. You can see that, let me drag this a bit to the right. You can see that our template actually is on top of our footage right here, looking perfectly fine. You can use this in your projects. Just drag in that template, change the text and all this, and you're good to go with that template, man. Really easy, you're saving a lot of time, and that's the good thing. Creating all these animations in Premiere would be a ton of work, but I've created this in After Effects for you, and you can now just use this template, customize it within minutes. As you can see, if we go to the Essential Graphics panel, it changed from Browse to Edit on the top, and you got the text boxes, the sliders, to adjust this complete template. It's pretty self-explanatory. You got the bottom text box and the top text box, which I've just changed to Vlog 200 and 1st May 2017 Germany. And you got a slider for the amount of noise to kind of make the top text a bit more gritty and dirty looking. You can adjust the opacity depending on your project. And as you can see, I've also implemented X and Y sliders to adjust the text to your needs. Yeah, same for the bottom text, as you can see right there. And if we now go back, you can see all the animations are still working, pretty dynamic, really easy, super nice for your everyday projects. Okay, let's delete all of this because we've got another template. So let's go to browse and install another motion graphics template, which is called fashiontemplate.mogrt. There it is, appeared in our essential graphics panel. And if we now hit play, you can see this nice animation, which would really suit channels that have fashionable, modern, abstract content. For example, someone reviewing his latest kicks. And yeah. We're now dragging our footage and drag this a bit to the right. You can see it blends in super well with the VHS effect in the background. And yeah, here we got a bit more settings to kind of tweak in this template. Of course, the text boxes again, we can change this to, I don't know, something fitting. Maybe fashion hall or something like this. And we also got a color picker right here. You can change the top text color. So let's maybe save this color if we want to go back, and I'm going to use a nice cyan or blue. Boom, look at this. And yeah, of course we got the amount of noise slider here again to make it a bit more gritty, which really fits this template. And same for the bottom text. We can change the date right here. Maybe add something like Gucci. And yeah, same settings for the bottom text. But now we got this new section right here, glow settings. Since you've got the glow on the top text right here, I wanted to let you guys adjust these settings depending on your project. And yeah, you can change the glow threshold, the glow radius, and the intensity. And if you're not sure what changes what, just try out these sliders. You can always drag in that template again and it will be reset to my default settings. If you now hit play, you can see all the animations working just fine, super dynamic. And yeah, looks perfectly fine, and I'm really going to enjoy to see what you guys have done with it. Alright, that's it for these templates. If you enjoyed this video, guys, make sure to leave a comment, like and subscribe. Check out the description to download these templates and check the upper right corner for more information about the motion graphic templates. If you have any ideas for new tutorials or templates, make sure to hit me up on Facebook. Until the next time, Armagan videos.